from wisconsingarden.net, and we are again planting baby trees. As you may or may not know, we had to take out lots of big trees, and we needed to replace them, and we've been doing our research, and thanks to YouTube, I mean, it's such a resource. We had a very thoughtful man who wrote in. His YouTube name is Council of the Age, and he told us that the Bradford pear trees that we had planted, we planted three of them, were not the good trees that we thought they'd be, that they are invasive and they're brittle. So thanks to him, we have now rethought our tree selection. We now have, behind me, we have two semi-dwarf Alberta peach trees, which are true fruit trees. So they will not only give us shade on the south side where we need it, but also eventually some peaches that I can. And then our huge trees, which we thank goodness our sun sky is going to be helping us with. We have a, let me check now just so I make sure I have it right, an October glory maple, which is nice and huge. I believe it's a hybrid between a silver maple, which is fast growing but weak, and a red maple, which is slow growing but beautifully red. And it's taken the good characteristics of both. And that's what we're planting for our main shade tree. Then we have also a heritage river birch, which will be a nice contrast to the maple leaves that we have. Then we also have decided that we needed a pine. I guess it would be a pine and not a spruce, which is a Bosnia pine, which has beautiful, it's a compact, columnar, dense growth pine tree that will get very tall. It will get 40 feet tall eventually. And that'll be a real nice corner piece. We also have another October glory maple tree on the outside of the wooden fence. And then, what's something I've always wanted is a weeping tree. And today we picked up a weeping flowering cherry tree, which I can't wait to get it in. I've always wanted a weeping tree. So that's our job for today. Plus, I joined the Arbor Society, and they sent us 10 tiny little blue spruce sprouts. So somewhere along the way, we'll have to plant those. So I got to get my muscles going now. I already had to transplant some things that were going to be in the way, and now it's time to start the new growth. This time when we plant the trees, we're going to use a root stimulator. It's for planting new seeds, new plants, and for transplanting. So we're going to mix this up with some water and sprinkle it on the root ball as we plant it. You can also get little packets of granular mixed too. It depends on what you're after, how much you're going to be doing. So this is what we're using for right now, and I'm getting it ready for when we're ready to dig.
So what are the proportions?
It's 3.5 tablespoons per gallon. And then they also tell you if you're not using a whole gallon, how much to use. If I can get it open. Using his muscles, he's making a hole that's twice as wide as the pot itself and a little bit deeper, and then we can backfill a little for nice loose growth for the roots. So that's what's going on now. I looked to see if it was root bound, if there were roots that were binding it, because if you dug this up in 2 years, it would all still be contained and it's still in the same shape. So I'm making sure that the root ball itself is loose so the roots can get out. Now I'm going to place it in the hole. Make sure it's upright. And then, ooh, wait a minute, I forgot that. I forgot my root stuff. My root stimulator. This is where you add this. You pour it right on the root ball. Now, what you don't want to do is cover up where the original level of the root ball started. So you have to make sure you go down and you find where it actually gets to the ground. It widens out a little bit, and that's what has to be flush with the existing ground. Then you put the rest of it around, making a nice saucer to catch the rainwater. On to the next one. Good.
Yep.
Perfect. Absolutely perfect. So it looks pretty good as far as edges go. Where's Jerry when we need him?
Who?
Jerry, our This is our last one. This is our Bosnian Pine. And thanks to Sky, it didn't take us a week to get these in here. That last one was a pain because we were going through all those big maple roots from the trees we took down. So this is it. This is our little last baby. The ball's falling apart, but here we go. Well, we did it. We took 14 trees down. We've now planted 14 trees. So we've got our river birch, we've got our two crimson maples, autumn burst crimson maples. We have our pear trees that we're going to leave in for a little bit. We chop them down here. We have our Bosnian pine, and we have our flowering crab apple and our weeping flowering cherry tree, and then over here we have our two semi-dwarf peach trees. So we've watered them in. It's supposed to rain tonight and for the next several days, so we may not have to water again for a little bit, but it's been an adventure. Our neighbors keep commenting, wishing we hadn't taken down the trees we did, but we're putting them back. Bye for now. Gotta go shower.